Welcome to Marine Tech Hub. Today I like to thank all my subscribers all over the world for subscribing me and making my YouTube channel Marine Tech Hub to the highest level. So I would like to tell a little bit more about my channel. I have been running this channel for the last 5 years. Last 4 years the channel was free. Now I have come to a level where I got the membership. So membership level 1, 2, 3, the level membership 5, which is ₹3999. In this channel where I am be giving you all the videos for 1 year, plus I'll be helping you for all the troubleshooting at real time from anywhere. So lot of superintendents, chief engineers and all engineers are calling me for troubleshooting. I'm very happy. It was my dream that I should have a channel like this where I'll be able to help people and shipping companies to save time and money. So you can always choose whichever membership you want, but level 5 I'll give you all the help, and online training I'm giving you online training for ₹1499. Plus if you want to subscribe, you can pay me. The bank details are here. If you want to pay through bank, and you can, if you want to pay through Paytm, you can scan the QR code. So I'll very much thankful to all the subscribers again, and have a nice day. Thank you. Welcome to Marine Tech Hub. Today I'll explain about troubleshooting with respect to vane positioner. Second is DP transmitter, and this is the air oil controller. So if you see in this picture, this is the boiler, and you can see one line coming, air trunking line, to the DP transmitter, and one from the furnace. So this will signal from the DP transmitter will go to the air oil controller. So vane positioner is also here, which will again push the positioner to increase or decrease the flow to the boiler as per the load. So our aim here is to identify. You can see this is the main burner here and pilot burner. So here we need to identify the fault. So how to identify the fault is, normally we run it in auto first and see what is the problem, then we change into manual mode. Here if you can see here, air and oil is there, green light is in air. You can change the mode from auto to hand and increase the amps here in order to find out the fault. So what I'm going to do is, first we are going step by step. So we have got 16 steps here. First we'll go first step here. First step says we must understand that the air servo error alarm gets activated by the malfunctioning of any of the three main parts. Okay, that is air oil controller, this is the one. Then second one is vane positioner. You can see this is the vane positioner, it can be a fault here. Third is the DP transmitter, differential pressure transmitter. So we are going to identify which one is at fault. Okay, so next what you are going to do is, our aim is to identify which part is giving problem to us. So next what we are doing is, we are facing a problem of fluctuation of airflow during auto operation. So it is an auto operation here, the fan is running, you can see the vane positioner fluctuating. At the same time you can see the air oil controller here also is fluctuating. So we have to identify which is the problem. You can see this is also fluctuating. All the three are fluctuating, so we have to identify. Next what you are going to do is, FD fan positioner, you can see here, this is checking the current to the positioner, and the feed signal from different transmitter all are fluctuating. You can see here, all are fluctuating. So next step, what you are going to do is, okay, so to solve the problem, we have to identify. So we will start the FD fan and then take control to manual, then see what we will do. Okay, first they are saying, okay, start the FD fan, just push this button here, so the fan starts. Then next they say push this, so all these have been digitalized for the easy operation. So now we are going to increase the milliamps here. You can see I am going to increase. Once I first, you see this is in the oil position. Okay, then make sure it is air position selected and make this in the hand so that you can operate. It was in auto. Then increase. When you increase, you can see when amps increase, this position also moves. You can see the milliamps increasing. Okay, so you can keep increasing, the vane positioner is being pushed. Okay, so this is what it is, and the next, proceed next. Airflow is selected on the, you can see here, from auto to hand I have changed. So I am increasing it. Okay, next what you are going to do is, this is in the hand position, you can see here. So the yellow button is for the airflow indicator, it's indicating here, you can see here. The next what I am going to do is increasing the airflow. You can see increase, what they are saying, you can show here, and what I was doing before, I am increasing it. Now you can see this vane position has moved. Now it is in the normal condition. You can see current is increased and the movement of the vane position and the airflow value on the air oil controller, you can see all are steady. So next what you are going to do is, okay, you can see the case 1, when a steady current is given to the vane positioner, you can see this is fluctuating. That means if this is fluctuating, that means it indicates that this vane positioner is at fault, because the current is steady, this should not, I guess, been shaking like this. Next what you are doing is, now current is steady and you can see the vane position is steady, so there is no problem here. Now there is only a problem with the DB transmitter here, so you change the DB transmitter, this will be okay. So next what you are going to do is, case 3, you can see the position is okay, you can see the DP transmitter is also okay, but you can see here it's fluctuating. The third problem is with the air oil controller, so you have to change this. Okay, so this is how you have to check. If you have any doubt regarding this, you can message me. Thank you.